In this episode, I'm going to explain layout images in Lightroom. It's a feature that's sort of secret that could really improve your workflow.
Adorama TV presents Exploring Photography with Mark Wallace.
Hi everybody, welcome to this episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV, brought to you by Adorama. It's the camera store that has everything for photographers, including everything you need for post-production like MacBook Pros and external hard drives and all that kind of stuff. In fact, post-production is what we're going to be talking about today, specifically a hidden feature of Lightroom. It's this secret thing that I think is awesome. Maybe it's not secret, but it doesn't get a lot of press, and I think it should because it's really powerful. Now, this is something that you could use if you're designing a flyer or you're doing a birth invitation or maybe you're doing a magazine cover or a brochure or a catalog or a web banner. Anytime that you're trying to take a photo and do a composite with text or graphics or anything that you would do in Photoshop or Illustrator or InDesign, well, Lightroom has this built-in feature that I think is really cool. So let me show you something. Let me show you the end result first, and then I'll show you how I did it. So in Photoshop, I created two fake ads. The left one is this summer savings sale, and it's for a travel agency. And what I want to do is replace this transparent background here with a nice travel image. And then I want to have a web banner that goes with it, big savings on all flights and cruises. And again, I want to replace this transparent background with an image that works. Now, normally what I'd have to do is go into Lightroom, and I'll just zip over there right now. Here are the images that I think will work for this ad campaign. Now, normally I'd have to take all of these things and put them into Photoshop and one by one go through and see which images work and which images don't and all that kind of stuff. Wouldn't it be cool if I could just hit one key and everything would work? So check this out. I'm going to hit the E key. Bam, there's my summer savings sale. And then I'm going to click on my right arrow button and go through each of these images one by one to see which ones work. And check it out. It's all built in. If I hit my G key to go back to the grid view, poof, it goes away. How did I do that? Well, it's called a layout image, and it's built in to the loop view of the grid module. So let me show you how you do it. So let's back up, and first let me show you how I created these images that we're using. So over here in Photoshop, this could be Photoshop or Illustrator or InDesign or whatever graphic application you use. Once you have your layout finished, you need to save this layout as a transparent PNG file. So I've done that with both of these images, and I've saved these over here on a folder on my hard drive called Overlay Images for Lightroom. And you can see here's my catalog PNG file, and I can hit space to preview that, or my web banner, and I can preview that. This little gray area here is where it's transparent. And once I have that on my hard drive, I'll go over into Lightroom. Now, here's the secret feature. If you go into the library module, that's where I am now, and click on View, go down to Loupe Overlay. Now, Loupe Overlay is just something that when you go into Loupe View, that it overlays something. Now, we've always been able to overlay a grid and guides, but recently we have this thing called a layout image. Now, all you have to do is go to Choose Layout Image. I'll click on that, and I'll navigate to my images that I've already created, and then I'll select one of these. So I'm going to select my catalog.png, and I'll say choose. Now, once I've chosen that, it's loaded in to my Loupe Overlay view. And so when I go to my Loupe view by hitting E, boom, that graphic is overlaid on top of my image. Now, the nice thing is if I go up to this view here, you can see Loupe Overlay. I also have these recent layout images. So I've got the catalog loaded in right now, but I've also loaded in this web banner. So if I click on that, boom, there's my big savings on all flights and cruises overlay image. And I can have many, many of these. I've only got two of them loaded in right now. Let's go back to the catalog. And so Loupe Overlay, recent layout images, catalog. Wham, there it is again. And I want to show you some things that you can do in Loupe View to sort of navigate this and resize and do some things. By default, it doesn't look like this. By default, I'm hitting the Command key, holding that down. We have these options, Opacity and Matte. So I'm still holding down my Command key. I can drag left on Matte, and you can see that the matte, the outside part of my overlay image, is getting less and less opaque. And that helps us to know where exactly to place this overlay image. So if I hit Command and hold that down, Now I can move my overlay image around on top of my background image. I can also grab on one of the corners and resize that. It's not resizing the image, it's resizing the overlay image. And that sort of helps me see how my final composition or composite is going to look. And I can take my matte back to 100%, and I can see sort of how that is. Now there's some limitations between zooming and all that kinds of stuff that you'll see when you start working with this, but it's really awesome to get a really quick and fast look to see what's going to work. If I want to see what the next image looks like, I just hit the right arrow key, or I can take my little thumbnail view here and choose any image that I want. And we can really quickly see what works. And once I have an image selected, if I want to see what image is going to work with my web banner, I go over to Loupe Overlay and I'll just click on Web Banner and check this out. I think, whoops, I zoomed in, hit Command so I can drag this around and I can look and see, whoops, I'm dragging too fast here. So I'll go back and see exactly which image works. Now with the zooming in and out, you'll see on something like this, that you can't really see the entire overlay image. If you want to see the entire overlay image, just go up and zoom way out. So let's do maybe a quarter, something like that. And then you can sort of see exactly what you're getting into. If I take my toolbar here, I've got my zoom, I'll zoom that back out. It gets a little clunchy. Is that a word, clunchy? It gets a little awkward when you're starting to zoom in and out like that, but you get a good idea of what images are going to work and what images aren't going to work. And it's really quick, it's really fast, and it's really easy. Once you have your images selected to do the final composite, unfortunately, you can't do that in Lightroom. You'll have to do it the old-fashioned way, where you take your image and you export that into Photoshop or Illustrator or whatever layout software you're using and do your compositing there. But the layover image in Lightroom is really powerful to get a really fast look to see what works and what doesn't work. Now, the other thing I have to mention with this that I think is really interesting is if you're shooting tethered and you're shooting for a catalog or a flyer or something and you wanna see in real time if what you're shooting is going to match the artwork and the design that somebody's created, maybe you've created it, you can just use your loop view with tethered shooting and see that in real time. It's a really powerful feature, and I think that more people should use it because it's a huge time saver. Well, that's your tip for today. It's a secret feature of Lightroom, and I hope that it helps your workflow as much as it has mine. Thank you so much for joining me this week. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV. It's absolutely free and you don't want to miss a single episode. And make sure you check out the Adorama Learning Center, where they have awesome tips and tutorials. Well, thanks again for joining me, and I will see you again next time.
Do you want great looking prints at low cost? Be sure to visit our easy to use online printing service. Adorama Pix has professionals who treat your images with the utmost care that you can count on. For a quick turnaround on photos, cards, or albums, use adoramapix.com.